In this video, we're going to finish the similar polygons worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the geometry section. Picking up where we left off with number 11, our directions are that the polygons in each pair are similar. Find the scale factor of the smaller figure to the larger figure. The scale factor is a ratio. It's the ratio of the length of one side of a figure to the length of the corresponding side of the other figure. And since we're finding the scale factor of the smaller to the larger, we're going to put that smaller side first. In number 11, since the two triangles are similar, 14 corresponds with 35. And 14 is in the smaller figure. So the smaller figure over the larger figure will give us the ratio. And in order to get that ratio, we're going to have to simplify. If we divide 14 by 7 and we divide 35 by 7. 14 divided by 7 is 2, and 35 divided by 7 is 5. So our scale factor is 2 to 5. The scale factor of the smaller figure of the larger figure, 2 to 5. And what we did, we found the greatest common multiple, which was 7, between 14 and 35. So essentially we simplified our fraction in order to get our ratio. It's the scale factor of the smaller figure to the larger figure. So let's use this side of 10 in the smaller figure over this side of 15 in the larger figure. Both of those are divisible by 5. So if we divide 10 by 5 and we divide 15 by 5, 10 divided by 5 is 2, 15 divided by 5 is 3. So our scale factor is 2 to 3. In number 13, we'll use this side of 5, and since 5 is congruent to 5, 25 is congruent to 25, so we'll use this side of 25. So 5 over 25 will give us our ratio. Both are divisible by 5, so if we take 5 and divide that by 5, we'll get 1. If we take 25 and divide that by 5, we'll get 5. So the greatest common multiple was 5. So our scale factor is 1 to 5. And since we're doing the scale factor of the smaller figure to the larger figure, the smaller number is always going to come first in our scale factor. 1 is smaller than 5, so it's 1 to 5. And number 14, we'll use this side of 35 to this side of 42. So 35 over 42, we can simplify because 7 goes into each of these evenly. So let's start by dividing by 7. And we'll get 35 divided by 7 is 5, and 42 divided by 7 is 6. So our scale factor is 5 to 6. And number 15, we can't use 8 because we don't know what this side is. However, we can use 14 and 21. So 14 over 21 will give us our ratio. Both 14 and 21 are divisible by 7. So dividing both of those by 7, 14 divided by 7 will give us 2, and 21 divided by 7 will give us 3. So our scale factor is 2 to 3. Our number 16, we have side length 30, 30, 35, and then 18, 18, 21. So let's use 18 and 30. 18 over 30 is our ratio. The greatest common multiple between those two is 6. 6 goes into 30 a total of 5 times, and 6 goes into 18 a total of 3 times. So our scale factor is 3 to 5. In number 17, we'll use this side 4 and this side 12. So 4 over 12 will give us our ratio, and we can divide both of those by 4. Since 4 is divisible by itself, and 12 is also divisible by 4. That'll give us 1 over 3. So 1 to 3 is the scale factor in number 17. And lastly, on this worksheet and in this video, number 18. These triangles are similar. However, note that side 12 corresponds to this side where we're not given the length. And side 8 corresponds to this side where we're not given the length. So we're going to use 7 and 14 since those are corresponding sides. 7 over 14, both of those are divisible by 7. So if we divide 7 by 7 and 14 by 7, we'll get 1 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator. So our scale factor is 1 to 2 for number 18. And if you haven't already, click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. And if you've already done that, feel free to share this video. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below.